So let's go to the Raspberry Pi website and download the API image, which is the software that will allow us to write Drumpi onto the SD card. Then we need the actual Drumpi image file. Let's go to the Drumpi website. From the download section, click download, enter your email and click continue. After a few seconds, you will receive an email with a download link. With the PI image installed, insert the SD card into your SD card adapter and open the PI image. From the Choose Device button, select PI 5. From the Choose OS button, scroll all the way down and click Use Custom. Pick the Drumpi file, but remember to unzip it before using it. Then choose Storage and select your SD card. Click Next and note when we are prompt any customization. Finally, yes to continue. It's gonna take a few minutes depending on the SD card. And once it's done, you can remove the SD card. All right, so now that we got all the juicy stuff inside the SD card, let's put it in. Also, we want to plug a pair of headphones, but you can also use the audio output so that we can hear a beep when the internal audio engine starts. That means that Drumpi is actually working. Let's plug the power supply as well. And so the first boot usually takes a bit longer, around a couple of minutes. So after a couple of minutes, we should be hearing a beep from the audio engine. Now, the first time you turn Drumpi on, it clearly doesn't know your home Wi-Fi, but because it doesn't have any screen, it needs a Wi-Fi so that you can access its user interface. Because it doesn't know any Wi-Fi to connect to, it will create its own Wi-Fi called Drumpi. So let's connect to Drumpi. The password is Drumpi1234. Now open any browser of your choice and type drumpi.local. This is the pad's interface. Any pad you will click, you will hear the sound from Drumpi. So in some cases, drumpi.local might not work. If you are the lucky one, you might just use the direct IP address, which is 11.42.0.1, which is the direct IP address. Now let's plug a MIDI controller. In this case, a simple multipad, but you can connect your fully fledged electronic drums. Anytime you will plug a MIDI controller, the user interface will notify you which controller you have connected. And this is a really handy way to verify if your MIDI controller gets recognized correctly. Also, the user interface works both ways. You can click on the screen and hear the sound from Drumpi, but you can also hit a physical pad and the virtual pad will animate. Then you have the mixer page, where you have access to all the microphones that have been used during the sampling stage. You can change volumes, effects, solo, mutes, Bluetooth volume. This page is quite packed, so probably I'm gonna make another video on this. Now, connection-wise, you can either keep it this way, always connected to Drumpi's Wi-Fi, or you can set up Drumpi with your home Wi-Fi so that you don't need to switch networks when working with Drumpi. So let's do that. Go to Options, Wi-Fi section. Now you get the list of Wi-Fi's available. Click on yours. Enter your password. Now Drumpi is gonna disable its own Wi-Fi called Drumpi. And because your device doesn't have Drumpi Wi-Fi available anymore, it should go back to the previous Wi-Fi it was connected before. So if your device and Drumpi are connected on the same network, everything should work as it was before.